It's Kiki, aka Shy Face Diva. Thank you for joining me in the kitchen again. Today we're gonna be doing my keto pumpkin pie. I went by this. I modified my sweet potato pie so it can fit into keto or someone that's a diabetic or just someone that wants a low calorie, low carb, low sugar dessert. I made this one several times last year and I said I have to share with you guys this year. Okay, so let's jump in. We're gonna start off preheating our oven to 350. Take a medium sized mixing bowl. Add in some almond flour, Splenda, and a little bit of salt. And you want to mix that together and make sure there's no clumps and make sure it's just really smooth. We're going to add in our melted butter and make sure it's cool before you add it in there. We're going to mix that up really good. You want a nice crumbly mixture like that. Then we're going to take a 9-inch pie dish. And you want to press it down in your pan really good. And it doesn't have to be perfect. Just make sure it's evenly spread around really good. Then we're going to pre-bake our crust for 10 minutes. Once you take it out the oven, you want to set it to the side and let your crust cool while you prepare the filling. In a medium bowl, we're going to add in some pumpkin puree. You can use canned or fresh. We're going to add our eggs one at a time until they're all incorporated. Then we're going to add in some Splenda. We're going to add in a little bit of salt. We're going to add in some cinnamon and pumpkin pie spice to give it all the flavor. Some vanilla extract. And you want to mix it up really good until it's well incorporated. We're going to be adding in unsweetened almond milk. And you're going to mix that up really well. It is going to be very liquefied, but that's what you want. Trust the end result. It's going to be delicious. We're going to add it back to our pie crust. It's okay if the pie crust disappears on the side. Then you want to bake this for 40 to 45 minutes. Mine always gets done about 43 minutes. You want to let it cool on the counter for a couple of hours. And it's going to firm up nicely. Then you're going to cover it and put it in the fridge for up to 5 days. You can add in some sugar-free Cool Whip, sugar-free caramel. Y'all, let me know if you want me to incorporate more keto and diabetic friendly recipes. Everybody deserves a treat or a nice meal that's going to keep us on track. Make sure to check out my playlist for all of my holiday recipes. I got tons of desserts, side dishes, and main dishes. And make sure to follow me on TikTok. And if you're into like candles and perfume and all of that good stuff, go over and check out Kiki's Candle Lounge. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.